Hello and welcome to TI Precision Labs. USB is one of the most commonly used interfaces in the world of electronics and can be found in many items we interact with every day, from headphones or a cell phone to complex systems in automobiles and airplanes. Most of us don't think about what goes on behind the scenes when we connect to a USB device. In this session, we will discuss the important role USB redrivers play in device connectivity. In future sessions, we will discuss the different types of redrivers. At its conception in 1996, the data rate of the USB port was 1.5 megabits per second. The interface was primarily used for a keyboard and mouse connection to a PC. Today, the USB interface data rate has increased to a staggering 40 gigabits per second. At such high data rates, adequate signal integrity can be difficult to maintain over transmission media commonly used in today's devices such as cables, PCB traces, and flexible PCB. USB redrivers are used to help maintain signal integrity, which is important for achieving maximum data throughput and electrical compliance. System impairments, which include PCB trace loss, ISI, crosstalk, reflections, noise and jitter, can lower data rate throughput and can cause compliance failures. USB redrivers are primarily designed to compensate for system ISI by using receiver or transmitter equalization. Inter-symbol interference, or ISI, is the distortion of a signal when one symbol interferes with subsequent symbols. For more information on ISI and other impairments, please see the What is a Signal Conditioner video. A system or device that has a long USB channel is more likely to have poor signal integrity at higher data rates and is also more likely to end up transmitting corrupted data. In a USB link, this could mean operating at a lower data rate than expected. The USB channel consists of the PCB trace of a motherboard or device with a USB device directly connected, or the device connected via USB cable, which can be as long as 3 meters, in the case of USB 3.2 Gen 1. A long USB channel with a highly attenuated signal must be able to perform as well as a short USB channel, which can create a system design dilemma in the location of the USB connector. USB redrivers use equalization to recover a signal from a completely closed eye and retransmit that recovered signal while remaining transparent in the system. By having the capability to recover a bad signal, the USB redriver can effectively extend the length of the channel on the system while maintaining the highest data rate available, which allows flexibility in the placement of the USB connector. The high-frequency components of the signal at higher data rates are more susceptible to distortion. This can cause bit errors. Emphasizing the high-frequency content at the transmitter helps produce a signal at the receiver which more closely resembles the original transmitted signal. A USB redriver can compensate for anticipated channel loss by applying transmitter equalization by two methods, pre-emphasis or de-emphasis. Pre-emphasis is used to increase the high-frequency signal components, which are more susceptible to noise. This is accomplished by increasing the level of the first transmission bit. De-emphasis is used to increase the high-frequency content by lowering the level of all bits except the first transition bit. As you can see in the waveform on the left, without de-emphasis, the signal level of all bit combinations remain the same. The waveform on the right shows the result of adding de-emphasis to the signal. You can see the first transition bit remains at the nominal swing level and subsequent bits have a lower signal amplitude. A USB host, hub, and device are all required to pass USB compliance testing for certification. Without certification, a system, hub, or device is not able to display the USB logo signifying that it is compliant to the USB specification and cannot be sold or marketed as a USB product. The USB electrical compliance testing is comprised of transmitter and receiver testing. Transmitter testing verifies that the transmitter meets eye width, eye height, and jitter requirements using channel models consisting of a predefined PCB trace and cable. These measurements are taken at the end of the channel at the connector. The eye diagram on the left shows a passing USB 2.0 high-speed eye. The eye diagram in the middle shows a passing USB 3.2 Gen 1 5 gigabits per second eye. The eye diagram on the right shows a passing USB 3.2 Gen 2 10 gigabits per second high. As data rates have increased to 10 gigabits per second and beyond, the requirements to pass the transmitter eye diagram testing have become more stringent as well. A system or device that has a USB channel with poor signal integrity is much more likely to fail this electrical compliance testing. Signal loss occurs across a medium, a PCB trace or a cable, for example. The amount of loss increases with length and frequency. A USB redriver receiver uses continuous time linear equalization, also known as CTLE, to compensate for channel insertion loss and inter-symbol interference of the channel into the redriver. The CTLE is a linear filter applied at the receiver that amplifies components around the Nyquist frequency and filters higher frequency components. For a USB 3.2 Gen 2 signal with a bit rate of 10 gigabits per second, the bit time is 100 picoseconds. The Nyquist frequency for this data rate is 5 gigahertz. The CTLE gain value in the receiver is set to equal the incoming channel loss in order to offset any attenuation of the signal at the Nyquist frequency. This CTLE value is programmable in order to provide a range of values to match the loss, which varies from one system to another. As you can see in this USB 3.2 Gen 2 example, the channel loss at the Nyquist frequency of 5 GHz is around -7 dB. The CTLE gain setting selected of the redriver is about 7 dB to offset the channel loss. The USB Implementers Forum, USBIF, is the organization which created the Universal Serial Bus and creates the USB specifications. The USB specification defines a reference CTLE to be used in compliance testing. This reference CTLE is implemented in software for transmitter testing and is used to establish recommended ranges for the equalizer parameters in a design. The reference CTLE equations shown here, one equation is defined for USB 3.2 Gen 1 and similarly defined for Gen 2. Although the specification defines the reference CTLE, it does not mandate the implementation of the equalizer to allow design flexibility. As you may recall, we've talked about compliance testing of the USB host, hubs, and devices not only consisting of transmitter testing, but receiver testing as well. What is shown here are the examples of results of a USB 3.2 Gen 2 receiver jitter tolerance test. In this case, there are 9 points tested at different jitter frequencies and amplitudes. At each test point, a stress signal with calibrated jitter and channel loss is generated and transmitted by the BERT, or bit error rate tester, and received by the DUT, the device under test, which may be a host, a hub, or a device. It is then looped back and sent to the receiver of the BERT. Any corrupted data bits received are counted as an error and the bit error rate is calculated. The DUT must meet the defined BER for all test points to successfully pass this compliance test. As with the transmitter testing, a USB channel with poor signal integrity is more likely to fail the receiver jitter tolerance test as the probability of receiving corrupt bits is high. A USB redriver helps to recover the components of the stress signal being sent into the system by the BERT and retransmitting cleaner data to the host, hub, or device receiver. To recap what we discussed, let's go over a short quiz. Number 1. True or false? USB 1.0 data rate is 1.5 megabits per second. The answer is true. The USB 1.0 data rate is 1.5 megabits per second. Number 2. True or false? A USB redriver can help a system pass compliance testing. The answer is true. USB redrivers are often used to help a system pass compliance testing. Number 3. True or false? A USB redriver is not designed to compensate for system ISI. The answer is false. USB redrivers are designed to compensate for inter-symbol interference, or ISI. Number 4. True or false? A USB redriver can only be found on a PC motherboard. The answer is false. A USB redriver can potentially be used wherever USB is implemented.